19 minutes to 2 o'clock. Michael Crawford is internationally renowned for originating the title role in The Phantom of the Opera, and of course loved by millions for his role as the hapless Frank Spencer in the classic British sitcom Some Mothers Do Have 'Em. His hugely successful career spans four decades and includes his triumphant performance in the hit show Barnum at the London Palladium and the role of Count Fosco in Andrew Lloyd Webber's The Woman in White. He's a multi-Olivier and Tony Award winning star whose acclaim encompasses theatre, television and film. And he was appointed an OBE in 1988. Well, he's currently back and starring in London's West End as the Wizard in The Wizard of Oz, opposite the BBC Over the Rainbow winner Daniel Hope. Let's have a listen to him in performance.
To see the wonders of the world, you won't need to go too far from home. Not too far at all. Dorothy, there are other ways to see the world, so shift your gaze to this extravagant appliance, mainly magic, slightly science. With no stressful travel plans, as you don't have to move from Kansas City, the Honor Bridge dissembled wonders of the world.
Isn't that wonderful? Well, Michael Crawford joins us now. Hello, good afternoon.
Hi, Jonathan, good afternoon.
That is wonderful. You must be so pleased. How's it all going?
It's going beautifully, thank you, yes. We've just finished nearly 6 months at the Palladium, and I'm enjoying it so much, I'm going to stay another 6 months. So,
which is fabulous news. I mean, I know that. I mean, I've seen various interviews with you, of course, recently on the Dear Old Auntie, the BBC. And I mean, there's so many people want to come and see you. You're loved by so many people. Do you prefer treading the boards to the days of being on television?
I mean, I couldn't swap those days for all the tea in China, as the expression used to go. But I do love being in the theatre, because you actually get that one-to-one feeling that is like no other. When I go to the theatre, my first visit to the theatre was to see Danny Kaye at the London Palladium. And it's something I will never forget as long as I live. And it inspired the rest of my life. So this, like any other show I've ever done, even Barnum, this brings in young children of 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 in their hundreds, and they're cheering and they're shouting at the back, and it's like when things are going well and they're clapping along with "We're off to see the Wizard," they go on this journey, and it is very uplifting for us to play. The music every night just doesn't fail to make you tap your feet backstage. You're just it's not a show that can ever depress you.
One of the things that you're celebrated for is making a role your own, of course, you know, despite the fact that it's been a while since you were the Phantom in The Phantom of the Opera. You say that and everyone instantly thinks Michael Crawford, because you are so synonymous with that role, as you were in Barnum, as you were in The Woman in White as well. And was it difficult for you to take on this role? Because The Wizard of Oz, I mean, we've seen films, we've seen theatre productions of it. How have you made it your own? How do you do it differently, would you say?
Well, I think the only one that would be my own would be Professor Marvel at the beginning, with the because the song was specially written for me by Andrew and Tim. So it is a very special song to sing, and it enables, they knew my voice, and so therefore it was written with that in mind, I think. Now, when you get to the rest of it, I played three other characters. I play a guard, which is a very small part, but I was allowed to design the costume, which has I had him as very broad-shouldered and tall, with a very low crutch, so that his crutch of the trousers is only about 6 inches above the ground, so it looks as though he's got this very long body and very, very short legs. And the kids like that, and I like that. It makes me laugh every time I look at myself in the mirror. Then I do the tour guide around Emerald City, which is a sort of spiff character, and that's good fun. And then the Wizard. Well, that in a way is exactly the same as the film was, the film version, which Charles Morgan played the part. And he did it so wonderfully. I don't really see myself as doing it any better than him. It's just the sentiment of the role. I love the sentiment of rewarding people by saying we all have love inside us, we all have a heart, we all have a brain, it's whether we use it or not. And it's great stuff for kids because they listen, they're all silent during that stuff.
Now, as much as I wanted to interview you and have you to myself, I have asked listeners to just throw in a couple of questions if they wanted. Yep. Alan, who's in Stonygate, said, for Michael Crawford, how did you land the most fantastic job playing the Phantom? And if you were asked to do it again, would you go back and do it?
So, oh, without a doubt, yes. I mean, would I go back and do it now?
Yeah, would you go back?
I don't think I would do it now. My voice has... whatever role you play, your voice adapts to and you work to. I'm not sure that I could sing Phantom as well as I sang it 5 years ago. I mean, I wasn't very well 5 years ago, and so I think I've deteriorated slightly vocally. But I got it by pure chance, and Andrew I knew quite well, and... I was at a singing lesson, and Sarah arrived early for her singing lesson, which was after mine. And so she was downstairs at my singing teacher's in the kitchen, and I was in the sitting room upstairs singing a piece called Caro Salve, and I was murdering this piece. And I finished, and my teacher kicked me out the front door, and then Andrew came up with Sarah, Andrew Lloyd Webber, and he said, who was that singing just now? And my teacher apologised in case he was offended by the sound. And he said, no, I think we may have found our Phantom.
Oh, fabulous.
And, I mean, it was just extraordinary. And so I then went and met him, and he said, how would you like to be in Phantom? And I said, well, not being a fool, I said, yes, I'd love that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I went away and studied RAL for about 3 months because I thought that's what he had me in mind for. But it...
so many best wishes being brought to you. Mark Willoughby, he emailed in, he said he's seen you on the stage in The Wizard of Oz. He's watched you throughout his life, and he wants to send his best. And also, this has come in, it's Carl who sent in this text. He says he saw you in Barnum, amazing physical performance. Do you still do all your own stunts? And then, I'm sorry for this question, can he still do the Spencer voice? And we've got about a minute left with you, I think, before I know you have to rush off and do another station, but...
I still do my own stunts. I mean, whatever I have to do, but I mean, we'd still do a good workout every day and keep as fit as we have to be to do the show, because you're working kind of 10-hour, 11-hour days, and so I do. And as far as the Frank things, no, I can't do it anymore.
Just like very briefly, I mean, you know, that always, every time you're introduced, you're formerly, obviously, Frank Spencer. I mean, does that grate a little bit sometimes? Do you wince slightly sometimes?
No, not a bit. To be remembered for something special is what we all long for. So I am extremely grateful for that character and having built him up and worked with him for so long, and for the public to have reacted to him and still have him in their hearts is very, very special. Then it goes down through generations, so like silent comedy does still.
Michael, lovely to talk to you. Thanks for sparing some time with us this afternoon, and all the best and good luck as well in the Wizard of Oz there.